I've used so many others in the past, but I do not really enjoy their services. So I love this one. There are a lot of things you need to know. So we have different domain registrars. So you need to know the one you want to use. We have not less than 350 million registered domain names and thousands more get registered each day. You know what the implication of this is that those good domain names that you know, because I understand as I am teaching you, you'll be scamming within your brain that you go and register your name for a domain name or a particular name for your business name. Let me tell you, that name you have in your brain, someone might have registered it yet, or someone will register it very soon. So this means that all good names, good one already registered, or will be registered very soon. This puts a lot of pressure on new users to come up with a domain idea for their website. That is the reason you need some tips to get a very good domain name. Can you see now the homepage of InterServer, the InterServer.net? Here, you are told that web hosting, standard web hosting, ASP.net, then Boost web hosting, reseller. Let me tell you the reason why when you log into some website and they are not loading fine is because of the hosting plan they bought. Is the reason why their website is loading so slowly. So you can see some pictures, the control panel I was talking to you earlier, e-commerce, free web builder, then cloud apps, non-profit hosting, student web hosting, and so on and so forth. So on this one, we have VPS Home and Windows VPS, WordPress VPS, and so on and so forth. But for you as a starter, you may not need all those things. You are just starting. So if you go and buy VPS, you buy VPS, already is costly. Or you buy this one, they are so costly, so many of them are not at more than 50,000 naira per month. So, and you see this one, the standard web host at $2.50 per month. Meanwhile, let me tell you, these people are very, very smart. If you get to buy it, they may not give you this exact name, they will have condition for it. And that condition now may be, maybe you want to host your website with them at either for at least 3 months, 6 months, or 2 years. We determine this one. But if you just go there and buy a domain hosting for just a month, they may not give you this one, this price. So their hosting plan, the standard hosting plan here is $5 per month. You just click here, buy now. Let's wait for it to load. While we are waiting for it, let's move a little bit further. So the tips on how to choose a domain name for your website is: one, stick with a .com domain name as it is the most popular, easy to remember, and easy to promote. Domain.com. Let me tell you, for example, this website we are browsing recently, InterServer.net. Neglect this man. Forget that one. I will tell you that is subdomain. That is all we know as subdomain. I will tell you about that. InterServer.net. So this .net, if they are not the one that owns the .com, that's so that someone will still go back and register the .com of their website. Let's try it and see now if there is any website called InterServer.com. .com. Let's wait and see it. So that is the, you need to think Luke.com. Not because you want to register Luke.com. And someone has registered it, you immediately switch to Luke.org. Let me tell you, after this .com, the remaining extensions called .net, .look.net, look.org, look.biz, look.edu.ng, they subjected to the .com. You can see this one now. There is no one, you know, it's redirected back to .net. Since it's redirected back to .net, that shows that they are the owner of the .com. Maybe there is a problem with that .com. They are now redirecting their users back to this place because this is the where we check the other time. We now enter the .com, but that .com redirected us back to this place. So that's just the meaning there. But if they are not the owner of the .com, they will not be able to redirect us back here. And we may mistakenly want to visit interserver.net, but we mistakenly enter interserver.com. We just go to that people website straight, and we'll be thinking that we are in the interserver.net. You understand the reason for that now. Other thing is that make sure it is shorter and it is easier to remember. Let your website be shorter and be easy to remember. Don't just go and write your first name, your second name, and your father's name and add it together and be spelling in that be spelling it as Matthew Alexandra Dewey.com. The users will be stressed off while typing your domain name. Just use a very small, just few words. You add very few words, and it will be interesting for yourself while you are doing it. Let's go back to how to search a domain name now. Now you want to register a new domain. Register a new domain. Have you seen it? Web hosting. For example, you have to a domain name before, you just want to host it with these people. You see, I already have a domain name. You just click this one. Then it will ask you your website name.com. Enter it. Now enter it. So if you now enter any name that is not existing, it will tell you that it is not, it is available. So, but this is what you want to learn for now. Register a new domain. For example, your name is Aboki. Let's say Aboki, that is the name of your website. Aboki.com. Just click anywhere and check this thing. Look at this thing, it's rolling. Wait for it now. Now see what it tells you. Domain already taken. Someone has registered it. This is highly stressful when you are searching for a domain. But the name of your business or the name of your company is something Aboki, and you don't want to go out of that Aboki. So you want to look for another thing. And that thing, make sure you don't add number. If you add number, it may go. But it is not a good idea. So at that Aboki, you may want to add you may want to add something reasonable to it, or you deduct something. Abo. Let's see now if that Abo could be. It is taken. It is also taken. Let's delete the key and see if it will be available. It is also taken. So how will you do it then? That is why you'll be hearing the domain name like Jumia. What is the meaning of Jumia? We do not know. They are the ones that know the reason why they put Jumia. Some say Konga. What is the meaning of Konga? They do not know. We do not know. They are the AliExpress. So, but if you want to make your domain name unique, you may formulate a unique name. A unique name. For example, you have established a business. You establish a company, and the name of that, the particular name of that company is not. It has been taken. Now you can use the acronyms. Either the first name of your, the first letter of your first son name. Maybe the first letter of your first son is A. Second Second born is Y. The last born is W. So now repeat. It is, can you see? It is already taken. So you try lots of things. We are going out from here so that we not waste our precious time on that. Then, don't use number or hyphen. I've told you. Use domain name, registrators, registrator to come up with clever domain name idea. So I think InterServer is doing that. That is, this is the two. You try these two. Try these two. Now, let's see. The keyword, Aboki. We enter Aboki now. Let's wait and see. Let's search and see. It will give you numerous options that is still available for registration. Wait and let it load it for you. Let's go back to our lesson. Come back to it later. Other thing you need to understand about the registration is how to register a domain name. So before you can be visible online, having and registering a domain name is highly important. This is happening to your digital street address and represents the primary way for people to identify your business or project online. If you do not have that name, no one will recognize. Can you see the available name now? For Aboki, we have Aboki.website. This is the total amount, which is available at $5. Boy Aboki.online, Aboki Center Online, Aboki, they are numerous. So we will not leave here today. But those things are not really okay. They are not really okay. The reason why it is not okay is because some have registered your .com. As long as someone has registered you could see that there is no .org here. If you have .org or .net, so it will have even better. But someone has registered your .com, they are now making this one available for you. But like a Aboki blog, .blog, that one is fine. But it will be advisable for you to buy it if only you have registered the .com. So if you register aboki.com, you can have aboki.net, aboki.org, aboki.org, so and so and so and so. You can see it, it's numerous, you can see it here. It's numerous here. So that is just it. Thank you for that, your child. So there are three main steps to achieve this. Choose a domain registrar. Find available domain and consider a way to protect your privacy. We have done this one and this one. It is only this one that remains. So let us just pick one now so that we can move further in the practical. Let's select Aboki dots. Let's say Aboki dots. Good. Dot blog. Let's say I can see aboki.blog. So let's register aboki.blog. Abokia. Let's go just for the purpose of invalid domain name, abokia.com. So, domain not register. So, not register. Aboki, yeah. Aboki. So, we are looking for anyone because I want you to see how it will look like. Not registered, but I expect it to say it's available. So, Aboki, let's say Nigeria. Aboki, Nigeria. I expect this one to be available. But not registered, maybe they have changed their system. Okay, this is the problem here. This is the problem. This place is looking for already registered domain name. Can you see now? First year domain registration for is, you see, 7.9. There is nothing different between $8. That is $8. So you now move ahead. Continue. So you now continue. First and foremost, they collect your email so that they can contact you. You collect your email, you put your password, you click agree, then you create account and continue. You create an account and continue. Let me enter an email here so that we can move forward. Then password, particular password. Then click agree, then create account and continue. So these things are not difficult at all. So can you see now already? Yeah, that is my own email. Let's move forward. Now they are asking you, what do you need? Those things you needed. This is the registration form given to them by domain. The domain managers called ICANN. So you must put your real details here so that you, whenever anything happens that requires searching for your details, those companies that host you will be able to trace you. If you don't do that, that shows that you put the company that hosts your website in danger. Let's put something.